లేకుంటే బతికే పండదుగా. ఒకరికొకరు తోడు నీడగా లేకుంటే బతికే పండదుగా. ఆడపిల్లలంటేనే లోకాన లోకువై పాయతల్లి, కట్ల కానుకల పంటవై నిండాలి. డబ్బు బంగారము బండి బాసములతో ఇల్లంత నింపిన ఇంతేనా అంటారు. ఏది తక్కువైనను ఓ చెల్లి నిన్నేడిపిస్తారమ్మా, ఏది తక్కువైనను ఓ చెల్లి నిన్నేడిపిస్తారమ్మా. నీ ముఖం పాడుగాను నువ్వేమి తెచ్చినా వంటరమ్మా. నిన్ను చంపే వంటింట్లో కాలి సచ్చిన వాని పేపరు ఇస్తారమ్మా, నిన్ను చంపే వంటింట్లో కాలి సచ్చిన వాని పేపర్లకు ఇస్తారమ్మా. ఆడపిల్లలంటేనే లోకాన లోకువై పాయ తల్లి, ఆడోళ్ళు లేనిదే లోకమేడుందని నిలదీసి అడుగు చెల్లి, ఈ ఆడోళ్ళు లేనిదే లోకమేడుందని నిలదీసి అడుగు చెల్లి. ఊడ్చాలి చల్లాలి కడగాలి ఉతకాలి వండాలి వడ్డించి తినదాకా ఉండాలి. ఊడ్చాలి చల్లాలి కడగాలి ఉతకాలి వండాలి వడ్డించి తినదాకా ఉండాలి. ఒళ్ళెంత వంచినా పనిపడవదోయమ్మ, తెల్లారే పొద్దుకే తిరువాట మీదమ్మ. రోజుకి 24 గంటలు నీకు డ్యూటుంటదమ్మా, రోజుకి 24 గంటలు నీకు డ్యూటుంటదమ్మా. 8 గంటలే చేసొచ్చి నీ మొగుడు ఎగిరెగిరి పడతాడమ్మా, 8 గంటలే చేసొచ్చి నీ మొగుడు ఎగిరెగిరి పడతాడమ్మా. ఆడపిల్లలంటేనే లోకాన లోకువై పాయ తల్లి, ఆడోళ్ళు లేనిదే లోకమేడుందని నిలదీసి అడుగు చెల్లి. ఇల్లు వాకిలి చూసి పిల్లల సవరించి, అత్తమామల చూసి మగని మెప్పు పొంది, అత్తమామల చూసి మగని మెప్పు పొంది. మగవాళ్ళ కన్న నీకు మూడింతల కష్టం ఎక్కువాయే, మగవాళ్ళ కన్న నీకు మూడింతల కష్టం ఎక్కువాయే. కూలి డబ్బుల కాడ మగవాళ్ళ కన్న నీకెందుకు తక్కువాయే, కూలి డబ్బుల కాడ మగవాళ్ళ కన్న నీకెందుకు తక్కువాయే. నరిసేటి చెట్టు అమ్మా ఓ తల్లి త్యాగాల తెట్టేవమ్మా, నరిసేటి చెట్టు అమ్మా ఓ తల్లి త్యాగాల చెట్టేవమ్మా. ఆకురాల్చినట్టు కష్టాలు మరిసేవు ప్రేమనే పంచేవమ్మా, ఆకురాల్చినట్టు కష్టాలు మరిసేవు ప్రేమలే పంచేవమ్మా. ఈ మగవాళ్ళ రాజ్యములో ఆడళ్ళకు అన్యాయమవుతుందని, ఈ మగవాళ్ళ రాజ్యములో ఆడళ్ళకు అన్యాయమవుతుందని. అరే నిలదీసి అడగాలి బరిగీసి నిలవాలి పరికి రామా చెల్లెలా, అరే నిలదీసి అడగాలి బరిగీసి నిలవాలి ఊరికి రామా చెల్లెలా, నువ్వు ఊరికి రామా చెల్లెలా, నువ్వు ఊరికి రామా చెల్లెలా. ఈ సమాజంలో స్త్రీలు సామాజిక ఆర్థికంగా ఒక కంపెనీలో పనిచేస్తుంటే భర్తకు ఒక కూలి ఎక్కువ రేటు, భార్యకు తక్కువ రేటు. ఎదేంటయ్యా మేమిద్దరం ఒకటే ప్రొడక్షన్ తీసినాం కదా అని అంటే, లేదు ఆడళ్ళకి తక్కువనే ఉంటుంది ఈ సమాజంలో కూలి, మొగోళ్ళకి ఎక్కువనే ఉంటుంది. మరి వాళ్ళు తీసుకొని సికింద్రాబాద్ నుండి తమ బస్సుకి వెళ్ళడానికి బస్ ఎక్కుతారు. బస్ ఎక్కినప్పుడు కండక్టర్ వస్తాడు, టికెట్ టికెట్ అంటే నా మా భర్త నాకు జీరుమెట్లకు టికెట్ కావాలంటే ఎంత అంటే 6 రూపాయలు అంట. మరి నా భార్యకి ఎంత అంటే నీ కోరేట ఆమె కోరేట, ఆమె కూడా 6 రూపాయలు. మరి మాకు ఇచ్చేటప్పుడు తక్కువ ఇస్తారు, మా నుంచి తీసుకునేటప్పుడు సమానంగా తీసుకుంటారు. మాకు సమాన జీతాలు కావాలి, సమాన విలువలు కావాలి, సమానమైన సమాజం కావాలని నిలదీస్తున్నటువంటి ఈ యొక్క సమాజంలో స్త్రీలను చైతన్యం కలిపే ఈ యొక్క కార్యక్రమానికి నాకు ఇచ్చిన ఈ అవకాశానికి పెద్దలకు మా భరతభూషణ్ సార్ మీ అందరికీ కూడా థ్యాంక్స్.
And it's lovely to be associated with Dr. Sunita Krishnan and Rajesh Rachriva. Both of them very nice couple. And you people, one day she was asking me, if we give a talk to the railway audience, what will they respond? You go. For the last 7 years, I make my time. Somebody goes for a movie, I will not go for a movie, but I will go to their ashram. See, there are many areas. One wants to go for a bar, one wants to go for a dinner, one wants to go for a marriage, one wants to go for a this thing. But I make every 3 months some visit. If I am going that area, I'll just peep in, you know, in our enquiry. But this is where our contribution is fine. Money is not the criteria here. How you are involved with the little, small, small kids. They're all small kids. Nitin, we have recently visited now, that Prajwala, just show that small kids. So that is where you are all required to. So much great job she is doing. And this is where, as a human beings, we also should involve ourselves. Think about it. This movie is coming. You take all, she was telling me, with pride, all men and women with children can go to that movie. But only, it will explain about how the people are, innocent people have been roped into this. I was also not knowing till I read about an article about her 7-8 years back. Then one day I shouted at her because she has not responded to my call. I said, Bada Babu ban gaya. Railway officers do not lift their calls. I lift here. Then she narrated me, no sir, when I go for a rescue operations, my phone call will disturb and other people may try to avoid these girls. That's the reason that 10-15 days in the rescue operations, we will not lift the phone. That is the reason I not lifted your phone. Then I will understand. If I give a call, if she is not lifting, I will understand she is in the rescue operation somewhere. Calcutta, Delhi, Gorakhpur, Pune and everything. She has not brought that film. There is one Anamika, where the small kids have been kept in the trunk box. Layers and layers trunk box, they have been kept. So like a machli market, you will ask this machli chahiye, then he will pick up one girl and bring it to the male. You will see, when you compare with a very rational man, you will see, like same machli market, ye acha machli humko chahiye, he like. This is very, very nice of her. She is going to 26th to Italy, talk about this thing. She is more known in the world rather than in India. She is not for any exhibitionism or publicity, etc. Both the couple are very shy. But I thought, I must make my, last time in the 7 years back in CCMPM office, I called her to address staff, etc. And then I thought, this is the gathering where we can make use of this. I once again, you have, it is her asana where they constructed. It is about 50 kilometers from Hyderabad. It's the model of, I think, Kerala type of house dwellings, which they built about 10 acres of land. And they are facing one problem is, the rescue women have been bought, but they have seen the easy money so available. That's why they are not staying back in the ashram. There are very, very few people trying to go away from the ashram, so they are very careful and they will be escorting. Lot of security people are there, etc. The small kid is there with injury. Some cool small kid we are seeing. These are all tiny cars. The bond from the brother business. Small kid, he got injured when she has taken care, the doctors are coming and everywhere. And monthly, an expenditure of 30 quintals are there for their ashram. We, as an individuals, we can think 1 month, we can give 30 quintals of rice that will survive for them. So,
and my husband taken a lot of risk by making this film. We sold our house to make this film. Our basic idea was to ensure that the world sees this message, And today is a very important day for us because the first film festival it entered today, it won the Best Feature Film Award in the Trinity International Film Festival, Detroit. So it's a big, big move for us, and I hope when it is released next month in Andhra, every person in this audience will 100% will take their whole family and show this film. It's a film made for a family audience. It's a film that's made in a format that is digestible for a family audience. And I would like you to just have a glimpse of the films. That it not only destroys the body, mind and soul of the person, but it also makes the person believe, this is my destiny. Getting raped by 40 and 50 people every day, for weeks together, months together, years together, till the end of my life, is my destiny. And that sense of normalization of exploitation, that sense that I am the accused, I am the criminal, and I like to be in this world only, comes largely because of all of us. Because of the way we treat these people. And that is why I would like you all to get into a very small journey for a minute. Just understand what that girl goes through. Because we, you know, even for rape victims, we have gained PhDs, you know. The girl is the one who will have difficulty in getting married, getting back to the society. She's the one who has to hide the face. The family is hiding the face. They are the ones who cannot go to the functions. They can't walk. They can't feel. But the fellow who has done it is Madhyada Purushottam Ram. He's like happily moving about. When it comes to sex trafficked person, even it's more worst. Because it's not only this girl. Her children, her children's children, everybody will be branded. We like to call them by all names. Lanja. All big, big names, we tapafy on their, you know, forehead, stamp. We don't understand when we do that, how we are being part of a crime. Crime of isolating and marginalizing people so that they live as slaves throughout their lifetime. I like you all to understand what this girl goes through. This girl's journey, and when I say this girl does not have a caste. This girl does not have a class. She can be anybody. She can be my daughter, she can be your daughter, she can be a vegetable vendor's daughter, or she can be a poor laborer's daughter. Because her journey starts from an optionless background. Now what does optionless mean? Optionless does not mean just economic poverty. Yes, not having one meal a day, it makes you feel desperate. But equally optionless is the feeling that I will die, but I have to become a film actress. Equally optionless is I will do anything, I will become a model. Equally optionless is I have to have facials at any cost. She's having facials. Equally optionless is a feeling, I don't have anybody in my life. I want to have belong to somebody. Desperate. I had, since I'm here in the rail nilayam, I am reminded of a case which happened 9 years back with me. This girl, at that time computers had just come, internet had just come. This particular girl, parents, actually railway employees, they brought a nice computer for their daughter. Pampered, the girl is high achiever, very good in school, very good artist, very creative. Mother is encouraging her, she's a very good dancer, adi, idi, ani. She started being very comfortable on the computer, internet, online, on the Facebook she met somebody. This girl is how old? She's 14 years of age. At the age of 14, she is meeting somebody on the Facebook who says, I am the son of a producer. They become joke best friends. Suddenly the best friendship becomes love. This boy claiming to be a boy on the Facebook, because in Facebook you can do anything you want, tells her that, you know, you come to Bombay, I'll get you a role in the film. This girl steals 35,000 rupees from her own house and runs away. She runs away to Bombay, and there when she lands, this guy is not a 25-year-old fellow. He's turning out to be a 45-year-old man. Even then the girl's, you know, state of mind which she is in has not left. She's still thinking, everything is thinking. So this guy introduces her to a lady, very smart, very good looking, very jim looking character. And he says, this lady has made, she is the, you know, she is the lady behind all the actresses in the world. And she shows certain pictures to the girls. What are the pictures? Pictures are taboo and compromising position. Some other lady in some other compromising. Some big, big heroines in one compromising position. So see, all of these people have done this. This is the way you have to get there. You have to, you know, every person who's coming to you is a producer. You know, you show your best face, best look. Girl believed it. Under the guidance of this woman, the girl started offering her body to every man who came. We got the information from Pune, where she was kept in a hotel. What was very, 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 very striking, when the rescue team reached the location where the girl was supposed to be in, because the information came to us through a customer who said, madam, there is this 13-year-old girl, this small girl inside here, please do something about it. What was very striking was the fact that she bent up the rescue team. She took slippers and bent them up. During the rescue, she said, I'm not coming. They dragged her out. By this time, she was already there for 10-15 days. She was dragged out. She's a Telugu girl. So they brought her to Hyderabad. I was dealing with a case. Day one onwards, no matter what you talk to the girl, girl is not willing to talk to you. Who are you? What are you? Nothing. We started matching her face with certain missing complaints that was left. 20 days back, there was a missing complaint from a place. I don't want to reveal the identity of people, persons. That's not important for you. Just important that it happened from one of your fraternity. It matched with one of the missing person's photograph. We dragged the family, we brought the father and mother, showed the girl. Girl saw her father standing, girl saw the mother standing. She refused to acknowledge them. I don't know these people. Who are they? I don't know. Is he your father? Father is crying, mother is crying. Yes, this is my daughter, this is my daughter. No, she's not my, he's not my father, he's not my mother. She's not my mother. 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day, 5 day, 11th day, I will losing my patience. The 11th day, I caught hold of her. I said, Mark, this is going too far. You know? And this is not the way you tell us. Tell us, where do you come from? What the hell were you doing in that place? How did you land at the place? Because the girl was obviously so smart. Speaks good English, she's speaking everything. And she looks at me and with that dirty look on her face, she said, you bitch. Because of you, I lost a film role. Can you imagine? For more than 25 days, this girl has been used by not less than 30 to 35 men. Yet, she has not realized the trap she is in. She still thinks the next customer would have been the producer who would have given her the film. And she also believes once she becomes a heroine, who will remember all this? You know, I will be a star, then all of you all will be behind me. All this, what has happened, will be forgotten and forgiven. Anybody could be that vulnerable. And in that vulnerability, in that state of optionless and desperate, and believe me, please understand, this can be your daughter, your sister, your niece, anybody known to you. In that desperation, somebody says, I love you, come with me, run away. Or says, I'll give you a job, come with me, run away. There is no logic. Because in that desperation, there is nothing called as checking whether this is right or wrong. Hundreds and thousands of girls are deceived in the name of love, in the name of marriage, in the name of a job, in the name of film roles, in the name of modeling. But every girl thinks that once she reaches there, it'll be all perfect and fine, you know. Once you reach there, everything will change. My poverty will go. Or I was just a student here, now I'll become a big actress, I'll become Aishwarya Rai or Madhuri Dixit. And then everybody will be my fans, I'll have glamour, I'll have money and I'll have everything. I have not met a single girl. I'd just like to make a little correction in what Mr. Bharat Bhushan said. We have rescued 8,500 girls in the last 17 years. And every single of the 8,500 girls that we have rescued, I have not met a single girl who told me, yeah, they took me for a job there. But once I reached there and they said, no, you sleep with 40 men. I said, okay, theek hai bhai, if it's not a job, we will do this. Not met a single girl who said that. Every girl would resist. The more you resist, more torture is inflicted on you. Because breaking in is one of the most important thing for indoctrination. More you resist, more torture is inflicted. This particular girl resisted so much that acid was thrown on her face. Inta kobbaniki. You know, so much of thing, arrogance. You think you are one Tripura Sundari? Her whole face was disfigured. Another girl was murdered inside the brothel for resisting too much. This is no, I don't want to do this. This picture was taken out of the cell phone of another girl who took the picture of this girl when she was murdered inside the brothel. Her dead body, never heard of, never reported, disposed of, as simple as that. But most of the other girls succumbed to the pressure. I remember one particular girl which haunted me for many days, many months, whom we rescued from Pune Red Light area, who said they took a blade and they were cutting it here. You know, until she said, stop. Another girl told us that they kept her for 8 days with a snake. Met her black and blue everywhere till she said, stop and do what you want me to do. Now most of the girls think that this immediate torture that is happening to me, I have to stop that. And they say yes to that. But they don't realize when they say yes, they are talking about a lifetime of exploitation, because prostitution is about a lifetime of exploitation. Exploitation from different kinds of people. There are 6 or 7 people living on the earnings of this one person. There's a brothel keeper, there's a pimp, there is a broker, there is a financier, there is a gunda, there is a policeman, there is a lawyer, so many people living on this particular one person's body. That means this girl cannot say, today, you know, Raksha Bandhan, I want to have a holiday. She cannot say, today is Sunday, I want to have a holiday. You like it or not, you have to sleep with 40 men a day. What is the profile of the 40 men who buy bodies for sex? Okay, shariram ammadan kolladanki meer velthunnarante, what is the mindset you have? Are you going there for an accountable relationship? Are you going there because you love this girl and want to make her a wife? Are you going there because you want to be having courtship with this girl? No. You're going there to fulfill your libido. And you believe by paying that 500 rupees or 1000 rupees, you have control over that body for that many hours or that many minutes that you have bought this person for. So what do you think? for that 1 hour, that one night, you will do whatever you want with that body. Our girls tell us stories every day. They will meet one or two customers who will put chili powder in the vagina. Or there are fellows who will take cigarette and hurt them everywhere. Or there are fellows who will take a belt and beat them up. We ask the girls, why do you allow it? Endukura, enduku idanni cheppistunnarante? They will say, madam, paisa diyana, double istunnaru kada. That means, if a person, man pays this much, you have to do exactly what they have to say. You have no choice there. And what do we think? We as civil society sitting outside, what do we think? We are like great judges, you know. We have the overall power to decide, judge people, decide who is inferior, who is superior. We think this is such a lucrative business. And easy money ki chestunnarandi, paisal gurinchi, inka paisal pichi, you know. Why can't they do some other work? How lucrative is prostitution? Yes, it is lucrative. For the pimps, for the brokers, for the brothel keepers, for the financiers, and all the people who are living on the earnings of this profession. But it's extremely expensive for that girl. She may be a 10-year-old girl brought from Nellore district to Hyderabad. From Nellore, they bring her to Hyderabad, some 5,000, 6,000 rupees is spent. So many payments are made in different forms. That particular 5,000 rupees is extracted. 5,000 into 2 lakh or 3 lakhs will become her principal debt amount. Now she is, say, 10-year-old girl. She's just attained her meenarki. Just now pedda manishi ayindi. Now there is big demand for girls who are virgin girls. Big demand. Which means there will be fellows standing in queue first time cheyadaniki. They will pay 15,000, 20,000, 30,000 rupees for the first time with a 10-year-old child. Now, this man is paying 15,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees at first time. Which means this bugger will not use a condom. He will have unprotected sex with this girl. Now, what does unprotected sex mean for this girl? It means that in 2 months' time, she could be pregnant. Now, if she's pregnant, just imagine if she goes to your railway or hospital, doctors will see her body. There will be all kinds of marks here. There will be cigarette marks, cut marks, that marks, this marks, because in 2 months, lot of other customers would have come and gone. 100% doctors will ask, what is this? Who did this to your body? So you don't go to a normal hospital. You don't go to a normal clinic. You don't go to a normal physician. You will go to a quack. Now if normal abortion is 8,000 to 10,000 rupees, illegal abortions for minors, especially illegal by quacks, unsterilized, unhygienic abortions would be 40,000 to 50,000 rupees. Who pays it? The broker will pay it. Who will pay the debt? The girl will pay the debt. She's further trapped into a debt trap. Every time she falls sick, every time she has sexually transmitted infections, every time a raid happens, police will catch and take her and put in the jail. I don't know how many of you know. Till around 4 years back, every girl who used to be in prostitution, children or adults, were arrested and put in the jail. It's only in the last 4 years that we have brought in a very, very big, massive change in the attitude of the police, where we have now stopped them and started making them look at them as victims. But before 4 years, arrested and put in the jail. Who will pay the bail? Brokers will pay the bail. What is the debt? She is continuing in her debt trap. In this debt trap, as she starts, clears for days together, she's sleeping with 10 people, 20 people every day. She's clearing her original principal amount. And in that journey, she gains a lot of other brownie points, such as all kinds of sexually transmitted infections, venereal diseases, gonorrhea, syphilis, you name it, anything will be there. She also gains health hazards like traumatic brain injuries. I understand from my girls, from having interactions with my girls, huge number of men like to bang the head of the girl on the wall as they have sex. So when you bang the head on the wall as you have sex, there is injuries on the brain, which is called as TBI, traumatic brain injuries. Untreated traumatic brain injuries is one bonus that these girls carry for a lifetime. Apart from that, day one you come, you resist. Day two you resist. Day three you resist. Day four you say, okay, Amma, I will do this. Now when you start doing it, you have to sleep with 15 fellows, 20 fellows a day. You're saying, you are in your sane mind, can you sleep with 15 people a day, 15 people a night? Obviously, you have to have something inside you to do it. So what you do? You start taking alcohol. In the beginning, you'll be forced to take alcohol. Slowly, you will start taking alcohol by choice. You start taking drugs, you start taking khaini, gutkha, alcohol, whatever, to keep you intoxicated so that you can do what they're asking you to do. And therefore, the extra bonus that you carry in your life is also becoming an alcoholic and an addict. Day 1 to day 10 to 10th month to 1 year later, the girl has given up on all of us for two reasons. You know, the broker says, the trafficker says every day to her, don't try to escape. You try to escape, we'll somehow catch you and bring you back here only. The police is also under me. The police will do whatever I ask them to do. Very true. Many of them do what they want me to. He says also one more thing, he or she, broker can be woman or man. He also says one more thing. No matter what you do, the society, the world will not accept you back. You know? Wherever you go, you'll come back here. Nadagandhi vapas vachestanu. The trafficker is a bloody criminal. But in this matter, whatever they say is 100% true. The simple reason that each one of us, because of our attitude, because of our perception, we have blocked these people from coming back to this world. So interesting to talk about the sus in this auditorium, right? It's so interesting also to read about all this on ABN Andhrajyoti or TV9 or something. How interesting it is to give this girl a job in your company or get her married to your son. How interesting is that? That is where it ends. So long as it's a story, fine, super, very nice. All of us are very interested to hear such a story. And also clap for the story. Maybe you will give me a few awards also. Put some garlands and shawls on my head also. That ends there. Beyond that, we don't want to be associated to bring back dignity to these people. This girl understands more than us. She knows if I come back also, nobody is going to accept me. My family is going to throw me out. Nobody is going to take me back. So why should I come back? I give you a simple example. When Bharat Bhushan sir told you about 2 years back, I moved from Falak Kuma to Mahbub Nagar. I'm not enamored by Mahbub Nagar. I'm not like very interested to see Mahbub Nagar district. I was evicted. I was evicted from that place by the community, saying that this kind of girls should not be around us. Right now, for the last 5 months, we are trying for a small house in Hyderabad city because our rescues are increasing in Hyderabad city. Every week, 8 to 10 girls are rescued by us. We're not getting a small house where we can run a small shelter. This kind of girls, this kind of people not in my neighborhood. This is the reality of an organization that is working on this. So what is the reality of that girl who's inside this? It is this attitude which is the reason for this girl deciding to remain in that form of exploitation. So much so that slowly she starts normalizing the experience of being exploited. So much so that she thinks getting raped 40 times a day is alright. Chalega. Getting beaten up by customers, pimps, brokers, police fellas, okay, no problem. But it is not okay to go and stay in a shelter home. It is not okay, you know, to have a safe life. She cannot even believe that. In a few years time, now you know she's there for 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. For a few years time, trafficker says, Amma, you've been here for 5 years. Take 200 rupees. First time the girl sees 200 rupees, maybe she is now 15 or 16 years old. After a few days, a trafficker comes and says, you're only getting 200 rupees, actually you can get 20,000 rupees. Why don't you go back to your Karnool and get two more girls? Now this girl now goes back to Karnool. Now she is looking very glamorous, good looking, jing jing, chak 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 and all nice prosperous looking dress. She says, Hyderabad lo naaku chaala manchi udyogam undandi. I've got a lovely job. Inka akkada two more vacancies are there. She is not a stranger in that village. She's our own Lakshmi, you know. Few years back she went to Hyderabad to work. Amma Lakshmi, ma ammai kuda edana udyogam ippistava? How simple is that dialogue? How familiar is that life dialogue? Just because all of us blocked her, just because we never did anything to rehabilitate her or rescue her when she needed us the most, this girl becomes a criminal. She becomes a procurer. She starts getting girls for prostitution. After a few days, she starts thinking, why am I giving girls to this lady? I can myself become a brothel keeper myself. ఈమెకి ఇచ్చి ఎందుకు 20,000 సంపాదించుకోవాలి? నేనే పెట్టుకొని 2 లక్షలు 3 లక్షలు సంపాదించొచ్చా? దాట్ ఈస్ ద కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థింకింగ్ షీ హ్యాస్. హూ మేడ్ దిస్ క్రిమినల్? హూ ఇస్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ హర్ బికమింగ్ లైక్ దిస్? దిస్ పిక్చర్ వాస్ టేకెన్ మెనీ ఇయర్స్ బ్యాక్, జస్ట్ 5 మినిట్స్ బిఫోర్ దిస్ గర్ల్ డైడ్. ఇట్ వాస్ అ వెరీ స్ట్రేంజ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఫర్ మీ అండ్ ఐ take this opportunity to say this in every forum that I go. My office is located in Charminar bus stand, which is just about 6 minutes away from Usmania General Hospital. This girl was admitted in Usmania General Hospital. At one point, I started getting call from the doctor who was duty doctor, and now, right now, he is my governing body member, Dr. Madhu Babu. Says, Sunita, can you come rush immediately to the hospital? Now, I don't usually have a habit of going and seeing a girl before she dies, because after death, it's only in the last few years that I've stopped conducting funerals myself. My teammates do it, but till around 3 years back, I used to be the prime person who did the cremation, burial, whatever. So I preferred going after and then taking the body to the burial ground or cremation ground or for whatever that is necessary. That day, strangely, I was called, and because it's the last wish of somebody, I rushed. So when I reached that point where this girl was kept, she said, Madam, can you take a picture? Again, very strange request, you know. You're dying of AIDS. You're in the last stage. Your face is not in the best of your looks. And this girl is saying, can you take a picture on your mobile? I took the picture. After I took the picture, I asked her, Peter, why did you ask me to take the picture? And she said, Madam, you give speeches everywhere. You go and talk in different places. You give speeches everywhere. Everywhere you go, can you show this picture of mine? To tell the world, what is the damage of prostitution? Why no girl should enter prostitution? What prostitution does to a human being? And as a tribute to her life, I show this picture to every audience that I can share. As railway employees are actually very crucial, because railway stations are come under you, trains come under you, and trains and railway stations are one of the most important exit and entry points. This is where people run away and come. Any runaway girl, any girl who runs away from home, maybe she has fought with her mother, maybe she has had a fight with her somebody, runs away, comes to the railway station to take the train. She's an obviously lost person. She's a missing child, but she is the person who can be most vulnerable to be caught by a pimp or a broker, spotted by a pimp or a broker to be sold into prostitution. And therefore, as railway employees, if you can be that vigilant about anybody who is, you know, looking in a state of direness, and connect to organizations like ours. Ours is one of the many organizations in the city. Of course, our kind of work is unique, but we have Childline 1098 is a number that you can call up any time and say, nothing else, call up 100 and inform ki we've seen this girl, you have done your bit. Yes, any donation given to Prajwala gets income tax exemption. We have an ETG exemption. We also have a provision where you can say, I want to give money only for education, or I want to give money only for rescue, I want to give money only for a marriage of a girl, or I want to give money only for the funeral of a person. You have the provision to do that. It is available on our website. You can, yeah.
Thank you so
much. But that is one of the simplest things that you can do, giving a donation. I would encourage you all to get more involved. You have your Sundays, you have your Saturdays. You are competent people, you are educated people, your skills are important. You can donate your skills, you can donate yourself for work. Those are the things that will bring larger fulfillment. You know, sometimes you people don't understand what small things by somebody can become such a huge thing for somebody else. One example is sitting right here in front of you all, Mr. Bharat Bhushan. For the last 7 years, every single girl whom I have rescued has had a safe train journey only because of him. You know, I call him in the middle of the night and say, sir, tomorrow 7 girls are to be taken to West Bengal. What do I do? He ensures they are given. You know, another railway officer need not do it, but he's doing it. You know, and he's doing it for the last 7 years, consistently, not wanting to do it. We call him in the oddest of the hours. So 10 girls going, 15 girls going, we have. Because, you know, any time we can be attacked by brokers, any time we have to be attacked by traffickers, and therefore, taking them by reserved coach is so important, taking them in reserve class. And he does that for us. Now, for that, for him, it's a very, very small thing. But for us, that's changed the whole map of how we function. And therefore, please keep thinking about how you can use your position, your privilege, your skills, your competency to change the life of somebody else there. And believe me, if you think and you decide, it'll be done. You know? That's the power of, you know, I like to quote Shah Rukh Khan, you know, don't underestimate the power of a common man. That's what he says in the Chennai Express. Believe me, I believe it completely, because each one of us is capable. We are very common, but we are capable of extraordinary and common things by our gestures. So I think, any other questions, please?
Anybody? ఎవరు లేదు కదా రవిచంద్ర నేను మాట్లాడతారా